Welcome to the video news of the week. Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital has sent out surveys to residents in the area, gauging interest in a potential new wellness center. The idea is in the very early stages of research and development. UCVH told the Chronicle that it is considering as a site for the proposed center the North Country Community Recreation Center in Colebrook, which has been closed since the onset of the pandemic a year ago. Hospital personnel anticipate that the potential wellness center would house primary care, community education, rehabilitation services, a pool, a fitness center, and an indoor walking track. High school graduations have begun taking place around the North Country. Last Friday, the Groveton High School class of 2021 held its ceremony with a return to a traditional indoor setting in the gymnasium.
I would say congratulations are in order to every class in 2021. You have played the game of school, and you have played it well. There were some challenging times in our last 2 years of high school, but in all honesty, I can say that I have learned to perfect on putting on a mask. So that's a plus.
I am beyond proud of each and every one of you for how far we have come. It is safe to say that none of this has been easy, but we've gotten through as a class.
Following the graduation, the seniors were escorted through town by a fire truck-led parade, where folks had a chance to congratulate the graduates. After 40 years with WCAX Channel 3 in Burlington, longtime weather reporter Sharon Meyer has retired from the position as lead meteorologist. For Channel 3, it was a sentimental farewell to the woman who has been the face of the weather for Channel 3 for four decades. Local television has meant a lot to the North Country over the years, and for a few generations, WCAX was the closest to a local station. Sharon herself often went on remote broadcasts, including reporting live from the Northeast Kingdom in 1991 during the station's First Republic 14-star series. She was back again 11 years later when she and news anchor Darren Perrin brought one of the Channel 3 satellite trucks to Dixville Notch to report on the Balsams Hotel auction.
And everywhere from the tunnels all the way up into some of the attics. And those attics up there were really cool. I mean, you find some of the old dishes, you wipe all the dirt off it, and there's the Balsams logo there and all kinds of neat stuff. There were some, like, outdoor deck chairs that look like they came from the Titanic or something.
Yeah,
they were up on like the second top.
Last Friday, just before her final reports that day, Sharon thanked her family and colleagues who she said helped make her long career a particularly rewarding one.
Recently, the Coos County Conservation District held an event at the CJEJ farm in Columbia to showcase a new piece of farm equipment available for rental by Coos and Essex County farmers. The piece, a no-till drill, joins other pieces of farm equipment available for rent through the Conservation District. The event at the CJEJ farm served as a chance to showcase the new piece for attendees, which included Canaan and White Mountains Regional High School career and technical education students, as well as local farmers. Those interested in renting the tool for their farm work can find out more through the website at coascountyconservation.org. The Carriage Lane Players are set to present Ray Cooney's Funny Money. The Players are at it again, setting out to tickle funny bones with this crazy comedy under the direction of Becky Bunnell. The Carriage Lane Players will be performing at the Tillotson Center with two matinees, June 12th and 13th at 3 p.m., and two evening shows, June 11th and 12th at 7:30 p.m. Tickets are $20 per person and will only be sold in advance since the show will be following COVID guidelines. Queen Square, along Lenoxville's Queen Street, got a recent facelift by a group including Lenoxville councilors and folks involved with Monshack Housing. The Queen Square project started on May 29th with the installation of plant beds. Last Saturday, the group returned, gloves in hand, to plant a wide assortment of flowers and vegetables. They felt the project would bring people together after a long year of enduring the COVID-19 pandemic. Expect a high of 64 degrees on Friday with a low of 42. Saturday warms up a bit with a high of 73, and Sunday temps range from a high of 74 to a low of 56 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.